Okay, so I have to cut all these promising black cards. I'm talking about these three especially, and some cards. I don't want to play and are not in my colors. I don't want to play Crystal Sleeper too. And that leaves me with about six cards to cut, so I decided pretty late for my archetype, so that's what I'm left with. I don't have that many cards to cut, but maybe that's not a bad thing if I end up with good cards anyway. Maybe this Hendgewalker will see play after all, but I would prefer to avoid it. But I don't really want to play two copies of Silver Flame Ritual too, but I'll probably cut one land, so that leaves me with three cards to cut. This can and for 20 creatures I have 8 humans. This is possible in aggressive decks. I don't really want to play it, but I can. I can accept it. I cut one land, and now I think Beloved Princess barge in. One Shining Armor. Maybe this, but I think it's good enough for this deck and Hendgewalker. So this is four cards. I would prefer to cut, but I have to leave two of them. So which ones will be? So, and how likely am I to support this Adamant? Because 3 mana 3/3 is quite playable in aggressive deck like this, but 3 mana 2/2 is very bad. So I have red Adamant spell and I really want to support Adamant here because 3 damage is nice. Vigilance is not that important, so Adamant in white can be neglected, but here I would like to support Adamant in white, and perhaps I will. This will leave me in an even split of planes, and mountains. So I think Beloved Princess and one Shining Armor are the cards to cut at this point. So not a lot of removal. Eight knights and two from Lonesome Unicorn, so 10 is quite a nice number, but could be better. I would really prefer to cut Hendgewalker for perhaps any knight. A lot of creatures, so flooding the board, attacking and hoping for the best is my game plan. I have some weak cards here, unfortunately, and some good cards, but some fillers, weaker cards. So I just have to count on luck for this Hendgewalker, because 3 mana 2/2 is very bad for my deck. So I can't delay playing it. It can be one of the last creatures I play, because I have many 2-drops and can double spell from time to time, but there will come a point where I just have to play it, maybe I'll have 3 plains or 3 mountains by then. I think this is the worst card of my deck. Hendgewalker. Maybe I can take another look and think what could I cut for, what could I replace it with. Maybe play this second copy of Silver Flame Ritual after all. I have many creatures, so it can overperform in my deck. 18 creatures is still a lot, and 2 Lonesome Unicorns create 2 creatures of 1 card, so that's something. Beloved Princess also benefits from playing 2 rituals, because it becomes quite appealing with 1 counter. The fail case isn't very good if it stays 1/1. Okay, so maybe this is the way to go. Let's play this second ritual and not looking for a place for this beloved princess. I don't really like this card. And an even split of lands seems appropriate. And this deck still isn't very good, but I think barging should Margin should overperform here with double strike creatures, and but it's a shame that it's a human and won't take won't get trampled from this, so it has to be unblocked to be worth it. But if it's blocked by some large creature, it's still quite nice to give it +2/+2. And I could use more removal, but it's not that bad anyway, so that isn't the main disadvantage of this deck. Okay, so I think that's it. Let's just hope for the best, because I don't like this deck that much, but maybe it will play out better than it looks. Let's hope for that.